When you're creating a website, what you're essentially doing is you're renting a server where you're going to store various files that can be viewed by anyone in the world by simply visiting your domain name. So how do web hosting companies and website builder tools handle this task? Well, the differences essentially boil down to how are you going to create those files, who ends up owning those files, and what is it going to cost you to keep those files on that server for as long as you need. Now, a web hosting service and a website builder tool have radically different answers to all three questions. So let's start at the top. How will your website creating experience differ? Web hosting services sell you an empty server. That's it. They don't really care about what methods or tools you're going to use to create your website. They pretty much allow you to use and do whatever you want. You're just renting space. But most people tend to use WordPress. It's an extra piece of software that's completely free of charge. WordPress can be installed on absolutely any web hosting server, really. So it doesn't matter where you buy yours from, it's going to work no problem. And since WordPress is such a popular choice, most web hosting companies make it a bit easier and fully automate the installation process after purchase. For example, this is Hostinger, and like the cheapest $2 hosting you can get. It offers fully automated WordPress installation right out of the box after purchase. Once you have WordPress installed onto your server, it opens up so much functionality for you. For example, if you want a pre-made website design, just browse the template section and choose what you like best. Click install, then activate, and boom, your website already has that design loaded in and available. And if you would open up and browse your server files, you would see that they're all there, created automatically by WordPress. Need to edit that template? Well, you could edit the files manually, but there are separate tools for an easier way to do it as well. In WordPress, they're called plugins. For example, Elementor allows you to use drag and drop functionality and just visually edit the design without ever touching any sort of code. Now, the confusing part is that WordPress is free. It's a completely separate piece of software. You're only paying for server space to store files created by WordPress. That's it. Some people might even choose to code their websites using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and then simply upload all of those files to the server, completely skipping and ignoring WordPress. Some might use a different piece of software like Joomla or OpenCart instead of WordPress. Essentially, it's your server. Do whatever you want with it if you buy a web hosting service. Now, for a website builder tool, it's a whole other story. You're not buying a server at all. You're buying their proprietary website creation tool. Yes, that tool was specifically designed for the sole purpose of creating websites, so it's extremely easy to use. In a lot of cases, it's going to be way easier than using a modular system like WordPress, and you'll get the final result faster. But that means you can only use that tool and nothing else. So as soon as you need something that it simply doesn't offer, well, you're out of luck. Now, this website builder tool that you're buying also comes pre-installed on a server, but you know nothing about that server. You can't see it, you can't touch it, you can't access it, and you can't interact with it. It's a completely closed-off system. The biggest downside of this is, one, you have no idea what kind of server you're getting in terms of resources and power. Imagine buying a computer and it just says $1,000 gaming computer. Is it a laptop or a PC? What's the brand? How powerful is it? And is there anything else included? Well, you know nothing. And two, if you need some advanced functionality, since it's a closed ecosystem, you can't really hire a programmer to add it in or use tools created by other people. If that functionality you need isn't included, there's nothing you can do about it. With web hosting, you're buying a server, and you can specify what kind of server and how powerful you want for it to be. It comes completely empty after purchase, so as for the tools to create your website, do it any way you want to. As for website builders, you're buying the website creation tool that just happens to come pre-installed on a server, but you have no idea what type of server it is. As a beginner, I understand that making a choice which solution is better for you is hard because you don't know all of the facts about your skills and your website needs right away. But sometimes you don't even need to make a choice at all. For example, Hostinger allows you to buy a server and then choose how you want to use that server. You can either install a website builder tool and go that route, or you can use it as a regular server. Or you can have one website using the tool and one website using WordPress. It's really flexible. And if you want to get started right now, I do have a 10% discount that's exclusive for all Hostinger services in the description down below. However, whether you use a website builder tool or just a regular server, you own your website, right? You spend the time designing it, you spend the time adding in the content, so the files are your intellectual property, right? Not exactly. With website builders, since you're using their closed ecosystem, those files won't work anywhere else. So for example, if you designed your website with Squarespace, paying $30 a month, and after 3 years, you found your big break. The website becomes super successful. For you, this is the worst possible case scenario because one, since you don't have access to the server, only the website builder tool, you can't really scale it up or down in terms of resources. The increased visitor count is keeping your site offline because the server isn't powerful enough, and if you want to upgrade, Squarespace can ask you to pay like $1,000 a month for a more powerful one. You think, wow, I was paying $30, now you want $1,000? That's just absurd. I'll pack up my files and go host them somewhere else. Yeah, about that. Two, since you created your website using their tool, your website won't work anywhere else. It will only work on Squarespace. You quite literally can't leave, so you're forced to either pay the new price or let your site die. Since you don't own your website, Squarespace owns your website. And these price increases happen a lot. So when you pick a website builder and invest hundreds of hours of work into your site, keep in mind, yes, you're saving time up front, but if you ever want to leave, you'll need to 100% rebuild your website using another tool on another platform. While with traditional web hosting, where you just buy the server, you completely own your files. You can download them to your computer and you can even cancel the subscription, and the web hosting provider will do nothing about it. Your files are safe and you can upload them to a new server wherever you want. Everything is backwards and forwards compatible. Any web hosting server from any company will be able to support them. That's why you can often see free migrations offered by web hosting services, because yeah, it really is as easy as yoinking the files from your old server and pasting them onto the new server. Now, the reason you might want to switch providers when using just a regular server is of course performance-based. Just like some phone brands are better than others, or computers with more powerful hardware perform better, so do servers offer different website loading times based on their configuration. For example, here are my speed tests from some of the biggest web hosting brands in the world. The difference is wild. However, what I noticed is that website builders like Wix, Squarespace, Shopify, and Site123, they take so much longer to load websites than just a regular server because they don't really care about efficiency, lean, easy to read code. They only care about how the website looks. And when you're using these builders, what you're essentially doing is taking blocks of pre-made code and shifting them around. Eventually, you'll run into artifacts that shouldn't be there or code that's not loading in the proper order. But while the performance is worse, the price is higher. On average, website builders will cost you anywhere from 2 times to 10 times more than just getting an empty server and using WordPress. So, taking all of this into account, when people are working on their first project, I personally recommend they stay away from these expensive website builder tools because they're not really flexible. unless they really, really don't care about the money they're spending and they don't plan to make money using their websites. I recommend people just go for a regular, cheap, couple of dollars a month server and use WordPress. Or if they really, really, really want the website builder simplicity, just use Hostinger. It's the only service on the market right now that's like a mix of these two types of hosting. You always buy a server, but then you can choose what you want for that server to behave like. You can use the Hostinger website builder and run into all of the issues I described earlier, but have the website built in the easiest way possible using drag and drop functionality, or you can choose to use your server just as a regular server, install WordPress on it, add code, or whatever, it's your choice. But what's important is that at all times, you're in full control of your server. So you can wipe it clean and start with a different solution, or you can use it to host both a WordPress website and a website built with the Hostinger website builder tool. Hostinger is also a lot cheaper than Wix, Squarespace, or Shopify, yet it achieves better loading speed just because you can actually control your server parameters. So my recommendation is save your money, save yourself the trouble in the future, and avoid website builders. They're a bit of a noob trap.